Hello friends, welcome to Macrotech YouTube channel. Friends, today we are going to start a new chapter, that is linear and angular measurement. So this is the first part of second chapter, linear measurement. So you can see here, these are the instruments through we can measure the linear measurement, right? So in first, it is a engineering steel rule. So this is a most common instrument we are using, that is scale, right? So here briefly explain about the scale, but it is not so important because it is very common. So here only given is how to measure. So you can see here, this is a correct method for measurement, right? So the scale is touch with the object, or we can say very near to the object. It should not be have some distance for measurement, right? And whenever you measure, you should measure with the like this, from here, right? Straight line. Okay, so this is a method for measurement of scale, right? Then next one is vernier caliper. This is a very most important instruments. Most of the industries use vernier caliper for linear measurement. So let us see about the vernier caliper. Okay, so if we talk about vernier caliper, you can see here, this is a vernier caliper, right? And we have two vernier calipers, that is, one is digital vernier caliper and another one is we have to check it manually. Okay, so these are two types of vernier caliper. So now let us see how we can measure in vernier caliper. But before that, let us understand the parts of vernier caliper. So you can see here, this is a lock nut. This is a main scale. You can see here, this 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, it is a main scale in mm. Above one is in inch, but we are not considering this inch right now. We consider only this main scale mm, okay? 0, 10, 20, 30 mm, 40 mm. And this one is called the vernier scale. You can also see from the figure, this is a vernier scale and this is a main scale, right? So this is a fine element, fine adjustment. This is a vernier scale. These are the jaws. This is a fixed jaw. This is a movable jaw. Okay. And if you want to measure the internal things, internal diameter and all that, then you can measure from here like this. Okay. You can measure from here, internal diameter, right? So these are the basic thing about the vernier caliper, right? Now let us see how to measure. Okay, this is a very important thing. So before measure, we have to see the least count of vernier caliper. So what is least count? It is a minimum measurement that can be measured by the instrument. Again, least count is a minimum measurement that can be measured by the instrument. Now this instrument, vernier caliper, what is the minimum measurement? So least count is equal to, we can say, smallest division of main scale. So you can see here, the smallest division of main scale is 1 mm. So here I would like to write here 1 mm, okay? So this is smallest division on main scale, and divide total number of division on vernier scale. So you can see here, in a vernier scale, total 50 divisions. How? 0 to 1 it is 5, 1 to 2 it is 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45 and 50. Okay, you can see here. Okay, so total number of division on the vernier scale, that is 50. So 1 divided by 50 is equal to, we can write 0.02, right? So this is the least count. This is the least count of vernier caliper, right? So I hope you understand what is the least count and how we can measure the least count for vernier caliper. Okay, now let us see how we can measure the vernier caliper. And you can write the in examination, if this question has been has asked, then you can write in your own way. Okay, not necessary to write the same thing whatever given here. Okay, you just read once and then you can write it in your way. right? Now let us understand how to measure it. Suppose I want to measure the diameter of this pen, okay? So what I have to do, okay, I cannot see the all the things in camera, but you know, from we can set it from here like this, we can move the jaw from here, okay? So now remove this and let's fix here, let's fix here, okay? We have to fix here. Now it will not move, right? So here let me come to closer. Okay, so this zero is just pass with the 9 mm and it is in between 9 to 10 mm. So we have to measure it accurately. Okay, we cannot say it is 9.2, 9.5. We cannot say directly, right? So it is in between 9 to 10 mm something, not exactly 9 mm and not exactly 10 mm. So it is in between 9 to 10 mm, right? You can see here 9 to 10 mm. Now what we have to do, we have to match this vernier scale with the main scale. So you can see here which line completely, say this line is completely match with the main scale, okay? So you can say this line is completely match. So this is 41, not a 41, but 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, and this is 21, right? So 20 number line is match with the vernier scale, right? So here what we have to do, how to measure the things, reading method of vernier. So total reading is equal to, we just cross the 9 mm, okay, plus 21 number of vernier division coinciding with the main scale, it one is 21, into least count, so 0.02, okay? So 21 into 0.02, right, is equal to, so here it is 9 plus 0.42, that is 9.42 mm. So this is the exactly measurement from the vernier, okay? So by this way we can take the measurement from the vernier caliper. So this is about the least count, this is about the least count, 1 upon 50. 1 is the smallest division on the main scale and 50, that is the total number of division on the vernier scale. So 1 upon 50 is equal to 0.02. So I hope you understand how to measure the vernier caliper. And at last, this is a digital vernier caliper, you can see here. And digital vernier caliper, through this we can directly measure. You can see the, this is 3.57, this is 3.66, 4 mm, okay? You can directly measure from this digital vernier caliper. So nowadays in industry, they prefer digital vernier caliper instead of the manual vernier caliper. But it is very important to understand how to measure from the manually in vernier caliper. So I hope you understand about the vernier caliper clearly. So if you like this video, then press like button, share this video to your friends, and don't forget to subscribe for more and more videos. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.